The following presentation was recorded at the Buddhist Society of Victoria, Malvern East, Australia. Please visit our website at bsv.net.au.
Welcome, all friends at the Dhamma. See your mind. That is, see how your mind works. Okay? Now, see your mind. If you listen to monk, your mind attention to my talk to monk, your mind got calmness. See your mind. If you listen to politician high park, your mind got a lot of thought and concept. Okay? Can you see your mind? How your mind work? When you listen to talk from a monk, and when you listen to talk from a politician, what different? Big different. Okay? See your mind. Okay? I just tell you, see your mind. Whenever your eye look and your mind watch, that means your mind got attention together, look and watch. Look and watch, you got your mind attention. Can you see your mind work? With calmness, with good attention, you already get into meditation because you got attention. And when you watch, see what happened, you see clearly what you watch, and you see clearly yourself who are sitting and watching me. If you got watch and see clearly, you got wisdom, or we call vipassana. Okay? So, just three words. Look and watch. Watch and see yourself. Okay? Now open your eye. I would like you to learn. Watch from your mind, not from your eye only. Your eye look. Now, just attention to my talk, your mind watch. That means your eye look and you connect to inside, watch with attention. With attention, you will connect your eye and your mind. And that is you got mindfulness, because your mindfulness will wake up when you not lost. When you open your eye, you look, but you not pay attention, you lost, you blur, you got blur the whole day. You got a lot of thought. But I just tell you, look and watch. Or the other word, not lost. Not lost your eyesight, not lose your eyesight, can you? When you not lose your eyesight, that means watch together. Look and watch together. You got already meditation. You can see how your mind work. Still and calm, okay? So this is how you practice meditation the whole day. Because you look or not when you work. Look at your job or not. But you not pay attention. You not pay attention, you might not watch. You might not watch, you might go somewhere else to your family with thought, okay? So practice meditation at your office. Look at your job and with attention, watch your job, okay? And watch your job, you got stillness of mind. See together clearly your job and yourself, you got more understanding, okay? You got more intuition wake up. When you see when you see your job and see yourself, see your job, you can see how you work well, okay? How you work well. And see your job and yourself together, you can keep yourself more relaxed, okay? Normally you have wrong concentration. You focus your job, but not see yourself, okay? Then you got tension, okay? But when you watch your job, see yourself, that is your mind watch your job, and see your mind relax and calm and still, then you got good calmness. But if you focus your job, you not see your mind, not awareness, and see how your mind work, you lose your mind. Your mind, you know, I watch here, I focus here. If I focus, I cannot see what that, okay? But if I just watch, I can see this is telephone, this is Facebook, this is WhatsApp, I can see. If I focus too much, I got headache, okay? Too close. Can you just keep back, watch, and have a gap, a distance? When you got a gap or a distance, you can see even yourself now sitting and working, okay? When you see yourself, that is really good calmness, right concentration. Now you just focus and never see yourself. Then you might lost. When you might lost, then you got suffering. Okay. How to see your mind? So just lift your two finger now, and move two fingers under your chin. Just follow me. Yeah, lift up two finger. Can you move your two finger? Not look by eye, but you can watch from your mind inside. Can you watch the movement fast or slowly? Can you watch? Slowly. Can you watch? Watch the movement, not imagine your finger. No, only in the movement. Can you watch the movement? Do it now. I will explain to you about how you get into meditation. Now your eye with me, open. Even your eye with me, but you can watch from your mind inside. Wash your mind from your mind, wash your finger. When your mind wash your finger, your mind got attention. Can you see how your mind work? When your mind wash and got attention, your mind calm. And I tell you, if you have goal in life, now you have goal to move two finger, to touch each other. When you have goal in life, you have more attention, then you have more calmness. Now just have goal to move two fingers to touch each other, and don't look by your eye. Don't look by your eye. Move under your chin, and can you just watch and do it slowly? Your mind aim, nearly touching your mind aim, and how your mind work? How is your mind result? What is the result in your mind when your mind aim? Still and calm. Doesn't matter you touch or not, but you got more attention. Again, do it again. Can you see what you see now? You can see your mind got attention because you have goal to move two finger to touch each other. And what you see more when you do slowly, attention steadily, then your mind become very good mindfulness every moment. Can you see attention every moment? Not lost. When you got every moment attention, not lost, that is very good concentration from attention. And when you nearly touching it, more attention. Can you see more attention? Now just leave your two finger. It still got good attention. But instead of wash your finger, can you watch how you sit? Your eye with me, but your mind can watch how you sit. Can watch how you move. Can you watch how you relax? Can you watch how you move, how you relax? Whenever you watch from your mind, watch yourself. You are relaxing your movement. Or how about you got shower? Can you watch how you doing when you have shower, brush yourself? Can you now brush yourself and wash? Can you brush your face and wash? Can you wash your hand touching on your face? Can you wash? And now can you wash even you just shave yourself? Can you wash? Or you just dress your hair, can you wash? calmness, and there you got mind become one with the body in the shower. What happened now? In the shower, how many thoughts you got now? Oh, more than 10, more than 20, maybe 100. You lose meditation from daily life. When you come sit meditation, you lost in thought. You will do meditation well in the sitting and close your eye practice. You must do well from daily life first. How you do well in daily life? Meditation don't have to close your eye. You can open eye, but can you keep attention on yourself, how you doing, how you feeling? Now again in shower room, can you just keep attention, watch and see yourself now, just take a shower, can you watch and see yourself? You got already calmness from the shower room, and calmness from the shower room will make your mind calm when you go to office. Now you got thought from the shower room, then you go to office, you got disturbance because you got thought from the shower room, okay? So starting from two times in the shower room. You told me you don't have time for meditation, but you have shower two times, morning and night. Can you just keep your mind with you, see yourself, not lost in thought? How? Just wash and see yourself. This is the time you stay with yourself. You just wash and see yourself. And also you got three meals. This day you got three meals with thought. Lush. Eating really fast with thought. But can you watch when you pick up and just touch and just chewing? Can you watch your chewing? No thought. Okay? Can you watch your eating? You got into the calmness already. Okay? Can you watch and see your drinking? 10 minutes. Just leave away about thought about your job, your family, 10 minutes on meal. Just keep knowing, seeing, watching, how you eating, how you drinking. You got charging your mind with energy. Okay? You know the car also need battery charging. If you run the whole day, battery may be broken. Your mind broken if you run the whole day. Now you have 5 times charging battery, 2 showers and 3 meals. Then when you charge battery, already 3 meals, you go to work, calm, very happiness, very happy, calm and joy, no disturbance, okay? And when you got mindfulness, awareness, calmness from daily life, okay? 2 showers, 3 meals. When you sit, then your mind attention here automatically. Before you try to focus, you use your brain to force your mind to focus. That is wrong meditation, okay? Meditation, it comes from your mindfulness. And what is mindfulness? Now you listen to my talk, attention, with attention. When you got attention, you got mindfulness in listening. Can you see how your mind work? Calm. Can you keep attention now on yourself, how you sit? See yourself, watch yourself. Watch yourself, see yourself generally on the whole sitting first. And then you can see this body not doing anything, only sitting, relax, and breathing. Normally, when you sit meditation, you try to focus the breathing immediately. That too much, is too much tension. Can you just see generally the whole body sitting posture first? Can you see? When you see, and you see what you are doing now, you're not doing any job. You only got breathing in. Then you see by your mind, God breathing in, and then you see by your mind, God breathing out. When you see, watch together. When you watch together, when you see your mind got attention, you can see how your mind work when you watch together. Now you see me because you open your eye, but can you got attention, watch and listen to me? When you got attention, can you see how your mind work? Seeing clearly, knowing clearly, understanding clearly. That's right? Okay, now open your eye again. If you, I just give you more example, so then you can know what is meditation. The meditation that is your mind calm and still by itself with mindfulness, with awareness. What happened? Have you been to the dentist? Now you go to the dentist. The dentist now open your eye with me. Even your eye with me, or you go to the dentist, you open your eye, even you open your eye, but the dentist now cleaning your teeth. Even your eye open and lie down open, but your mind only was here. Your mind was here only. Can you see your mind was here only? Because you're not sure good dentist or not. Okay, maybe accident. Can you see how your mind work? Get into meditation already. Calmness. Because your mind got attention. Your attention here, or you go to dentist, you still worry, thinking about your family? No. Your mind only attention here. Because this is now the moment you are now have to be careful. Okay? The dentist cleaning your teeth, and if the dentist say you got this one problem, need to take out, maybe it take 10 minutes to take your tooth out. Your attention is only here, watch here. Can you see how your mind wash? How your mind wash? Because this is pain, your mind will go back. It's pain, your mind go back. But when you have delicious food, eat delicious food, you go close, forward. And when you go forward, we call you got desire. When you got desire, eat delicious food, you never see yourself or never see what you eat, okay, or how you eat, because you got desire. Desire, how you know you got desire? Desire, your mind will move forward. When you go shopping, always your mind move forward. But when you go to the dentist, your mind move backwards. Move backwards is mindfulness. Move forward is desire. Can you see your mind turn outwards or turn inwards? If you see your mind turn inwards, that is you see your mind get into meditation. When it's meditation come, your mind turn inwards. Okay? So can you see your mind turn inwards? When you went to go to the dentist, cleaning, your mind only turn inwards, not lost in thought, go outward, turn inwards and stay here and now, watch and see clearly how the dentist clean your teeth, how the dentist take 10, 15 minutes to take your tooth out. You stay here only. That is you got calmness during the dentist take your tooth out, maybe 15 minutes you stay here, don't think anything, just stay here, watch and mindful awareness together. Then you have really good calmness. Can you got good calmness like when you go to dentist? You understand already. Now I just tell you, get into meditation, just realize how you are feeling with your calmness when you go to dentist. Mindful and aware and see and watch and see only yourself. But now you not do anything with your teeth. You just mindful and aware, seeing yourself, how you doing, how you feeling. You got only how you doing, how you feeling. because you got body and mind. Okay? Can you see how you're doing? By mind, not by eye. Your eye with me, open your eye again. I will give you more example. Open your eye. Your eye seeing me, your eye cannot see in your mouth. Can you watch your eating now? Your eye cannot look inside your mouth. But when you eating, can you watch how you eat? You get into meditation already because you watch yourself. And this is, you watch body in the body. The Buddha teaching in the four foundations of mindfulness. Watch the body and watch the body in the body. The primary body inside, just make it easy. Can you wash in your mouth? This is body inside. Can you wash in your mouth four element? Your eye open and with me, but can you wash warm and see warm in your mouth? Can you see in your mouth got warm inside? Can you see? That is, you got mindfulness and your mind wash. And when your mind wash, when you wash yourself, you don't use your eye. Okay? When you wash yourself, you use your mind directly. Can you wash water element, the flame in your mouth? It doesn't matter how you wash or what you wash, fire element or water element. When you wash body in the body, really good calmness. Can you wash body in the body, in your mouth? Emptiness. Many practitioners, they never wash body in the body. Okay? They only wash the breathing in. This is breathing outside. Can you wash breathing inside? Breathing inside is the body in the body. So that's why the Buddha start with breathing in long. Open your eye, because I would like you to be able to wash your breathing from your mind. Normally, you not wash from your mind. You wash from your brain, because you start with the short breathing. You focus here. You use your brain. That's why the Buddha know that how to train you wash your breathing from your mind. How? Normally, when you watch something in front, you use your eye and brain. Because this is, okay, I can look and watch in front, okay? But when you want to watch from your mind, can you watch on your seat? Your eye don't look. Can you watch on your seat how soft or hard the cushion is? Can you watch? Where you watch from? Your mind, not your eye. Your eye with me. So open your eye, because today you must learn how to watch from your mind. That is right concentration. Okay? And now, breathing in long. We start with breathing in long. It's long into your body vertically. You cannot look by your eye. Now, can you watch now? Just breathing in long and watch and see breathing in long. You watch and see from mind. You don't watch from your eye. Don't look by eye. But when you start breathing meditation, most practitioners always start with focus the breath here. It's difficult. If you focus something in front, difficult to see. You focus from your brain, your eye, or your mind. So that's why breathing in long is going inside. Now your eye with me. Can you watch and see? It look like you watch and see your breathing going inside from top view. Top view. Can you see breathing in into your body? And don't have to glance your eye to look. Just watch directly from your mind. It look like your mind can watch and see 360 degree. Now watch and see. Like from the top view, can you see breathing in long? Can? This is how to have right concentration from your mind. And then when you was breathing it long, when you got calmness, it becomes shorter. Can you, if you can see breathing and watch breathing it long from your mind, when breathing becomes shorter, you can watch and see from your mind also, okay? Then it becomes shorter. Even shorter, you can watch and see from your mind, okay? So start with breathing long to make sure you watch from your mind. Normally you try to use your brain to think about your breathing or force your breathing short and slowly and soft. You try to breathe. You do breathing meditation, but the Buddha not teaching breathing meditation. The Buddha teaching mindfulness of breathing. That means you just breathing naturally. When you breathing naturally, it become deep and long into your lung, inside your body, that's right? And you just mindful, seeing and watch together. Now you make me say, you practice breathing meditation, but the Buddha teaching mindfulness of breathing. It's so much different, okay? Mindfulness of breathing. If mindfulness of breathing, even now your eye with me, can you mindful of your breathing? You are breathing or not? We not practice breathing meditation, we practice mindfulness of breathing. Can you be mindful how your breathing is? Rough, gross, or softer? Can you be mindful if your breathing gross, glossy, or soft, softer? Can you be mindful? Mindful thing from your mind. And now, can you just more awareness together? Awareness is from heart. Open your eye, I will teach you awareness. When you are breathing shorter, softer, usually you fall asleep. Breathing softer, you fall asleep. Before, I also fall asleep. But if you use your awareness from heart. Now open your eye, how to use your awareness from heart. Just feeling your natural breathing first. Can you feel your breathing? Don't have to watch. Now I'm teaching you awareness. First, I'm teaching you mindfulness to watch, but you don't have good awareness enough. When breathing soft, then your 5 minutes fallen, lost, and fall asleep. Even you look at me, but can you feel from your heart? Can you feel from your heart on your body? Generally, can you feel? Cool or sweat, can you feel? And how about can you feel your breathing? Open your eye, because when you open eye, it will help you get more awareness, wake up. So my master, before closing eye, he open eye about 2-3 minutes first to bring up more power of awareness, okay? How? Now your eye open. Your heart awareness more open. If you start immediately close your eye, heart awareness not wake up yet. You close your eye, then it go to fall asleep, okay? Eye open 2-3 minutes will help more awareness, okay? Now eye open and not focus anything, just see generally and see yourself, don't focus anything, but just feel from heart. How are you today? How you are relaxing? And how you are breathing? Huh? Can you feel? Feeling, then wash. Eye open, so then I tell you wash, not by eye, but wash from your mind. How to wash from your mind? Keep attention. Can you feel your breathing naturally, but keep attention on how your breathing is? Can you keep attention? Keep attention, you turn inwards your mind to watch. And you feel your breathing together, then even your breathing will become soft, subtle. Before your breathing soft, subtle, you watch your breathing, you cannot see your breathing because it's so soft, and then you fall asleep. But now starting with awareness first, open your eye again. Even you're reading soft or softly, subtle or deeply, can you see? Can you watch? Watch together, just two words, feeling and watch. Feel your breathing now and watch. Feel your breathing in and watch. I show you something, open your eye again. If you feel your right hand, your right shoulder, now feel your right shoulder, even your eye with me. When you feel your move your right shoulder, feel your right shoulder, your mind watch because you feel here. Even your eye with me, but when you feel your right shoulder, your mind will watch. Okay? Because your mind will watch whatever you feel. Feel your left shoulder, your mind watch or not? Your eye cannot look at your back. But can you feel your back sweat or cool or warm on your back? Can you feel? Can you feel? If you can feel, you can watch and see from your mind. So wake up your heart by awareness. How to wake up your heart by awareness? Feeling yourself. Now just practice awareness more by feeling yourself, because all of you are very good concentration, too much. It's good, but too much, because you don't have awareness good enough. So just balance concentration and awareness together. Then it's just feeling your relaxing and watch. Feeling your warm or cool and watch. Feeling your sweat generally on the whole body, the back. Can you feel the back with whatever cool or warm and wash? Okay? And now can you just bring your awareness from the whole body, come to your breathing? So you know, just draw your awareness to your breathing and wash. This is right concentration. But if you wash immediately with poor awareness. Now, I tell you, draw awareness, come to your breathing by feeling your breathing. Even you open your eye, if you feel your breathing, you can see your breathing good, nice, or soft, or not soft, or a bit glossy. Okay, now, just two words. Feeling and watch. Watch what you feel. Feel what you watch. Can you develop? This is your mind, watch. Your heart, feeling. Okay, start from your body first. Can you feel yourself on the body and watch? Generally, can you see generally? And now, back up again. I will show you something, the new thing that you never learn. You never watch back. Open your eye, I show you something. Woman got long hair. What happened? You always see and watch forward. Can you just dress your hair like this? You are seeing turn inwards or not, turn back or not? You are seeing turn back or not? Turn back or not? This is how to turn back. Okay? Oh, okay, I have no long hair. you and men got short hair. Can you just move your hair like this? Show me. Can you see? By turning back and see backwards and see, you got backwards and see, turning backwards and see, turning backwards and see, can you turn backwards and see? And what happened? When you see by turning back, you get into emptiness already. More than meditation, more than calmness. Now again, you got thought. I give you technique. Can you just see your hand movement back 3 times, 4 times? Emptiness of thought. That's right. So, you know, the way of enlightenment, the first enlightenment is Sotaban. You know Sota Patimak, Sota Patipon. You know Sotaban? You know Sotaban? The first enlightenment we call stream enterer. Sotaban, mind always turn inward, see himself. How he sit, how he walk, how he standing, how he eating, but how you know seeing by turning inwards. Move your hand again. Even your eye with me, but your mind turn inwards and see hand movement or not? Emptiness of thought. But even you not move your hand, can you see yourself from here in front to the back? Can you see from here in front how you feeling from in front to how you feeling on your back? Can you? This is equanimity of mind. When you see non-duality, no in front, no back, that is see both in front and back. Can you sit? If you sit, can you see from in front to the back? Can you? If cannot, just move your hand. Can you see in front and your hand movement to the back? Move your hand again. Can you see in front? Of course, you can see in front. But can you see in front and the back together? Together? Emptiness or shunyata. Because you see non-duality. Okay, again. Now you look at me, but can you see far and near to yourself? Can you see master and can you see yourself together? How you sit? I can see all of you, but together I see myself how I sit. I can see far and near together. Can you see far and near together? This is you already get into emptiness. You go beyond concentration, go beyond calmness meditation because you see non-duality. Again, can you see from here to here? All people in this room, even you watch in front, but together, can you see from the left to the right? Emptiness already. If you can see non-duality, far and near, and all around, left and right, and if you wake up, you can see even in front and behind. If you become Sotaban, you can see in front and behind, and you can see outside and inside. Can you see from outside on your body, feeling, and together see inside your feeling of your heart? Can you see feeling outside and feeling inside your heart? Feeling on the body and feeling in your heart? Can you see? Non-duality. Emptiness or sunyata. Okay? So today I start with emptiness. Somebody can follow me. Somebody cannot. Never mind. That's all okay. If you cannot, then you have to come this weekend, Saturday, Sunday. I will bring you step by step. But today, I think somebody have good basic of meditation. but don't know how to see. Okay? Now, open your eye. Can you see your body in the front and in the back? I will tell you, if you close your eye, can you see back and the front and the back together? Feeling? Can you see feeling the front and the back of your body together? That means you see the whole body from front and the back to the back. You got emptiness and you not fall asleep. You see it more awareness and more wake up open. Normally you lost. You only watch and see the front, breathing in, breathing out. But I just tell you, seeing the long breathing first, then you can see breathing the front outside and inside the breathing. But today I give you special training. Can you see even only on your body? If you can see the front and the back, open the eye, can you see? Cross your eye, can you see? Can you see feeling on the front and the back of your body? Just stay in between. I just use the word. Can you stay in between? See no front, no back. See all front and back, both front and back. Can you stay in between? And how about you stay in between, see outside and inside? How you doing? How you feeling? Stay there for 5 minutes. Today, I wake you up by seeing in between. Outside, inside, in between, front and back, in between. And then breathing become natural breathing and you not involved because you already got equanimity of mind when you see in between. And now I stay in between, see myself in between. You just see in between, see the whole body from the front to the back. Then you can see outside to inside. And don't have to think to do anything. Just see non-duality, no front, no back, no outside, no inside. That means see all together, outside, inside, or front and back, all together. Can you see all together? Your mind go to emptiness. And your body become uprising, straight up, before you focus, until your body bending, and go down for asleep. But when you see both front and the back first of your body, then you can see both breathing outside and inside. That means you can see breathing from the starting outside at your nostril and breathing long inside. And just stay there with quietness, seeing non-duality, see whole thing regarding yourself, body and feeling, outside and inside. In this way, you got vipassana, seeing the whole body and mind as thought or feeling, you can see whole. And body, you can see whole, the body posture and the breath body, inhale and outhale. Stay there. Even you open eye, can you see first the whole body sitting posture clearly? From here to from the front to the back, can you? When you open eye, hot water. Even open eye, can you? If you can see front and the back together, starting from the body, see the whole body, posture, sitting posture, then you can see body and mind. That is calmness in your mind, no thought, and calmness in your heart, no desire, freedom from all attachment. And can you stay in between? Maybe you can, 5 or 10 minutes, not longer. When I keep talk, I need hot water because my voice maybe got problem. Anyhow, when you can see front and the back, I give you technique. This is my discovery myself. Before I got the same problem with you, sitting and your my body always go down. But one day I just sit and see by opening eye, see from the front to the back, my mind wake up. Okay? When my mind wake up, even I close my eye, I stay there. In between, see from the front to back. And after that, when you see from the front to the back of the body, you can see more of your breathing together. Okay? Before you forget your breathing, you not see your body. Then you not go very well. You can do well maybe 10 minutes for concentration. Cannot stay for long, okay? Because it look like you not stay on the liver. You jump into the water to see dirtiness in the water, then you lost, okay? So now the Buddha always tell monk, start with mindfulness of body first. We call Kayakata Sati. Hot water, cold water cannot. Cold water obstruct my voice. Okay? Warm. Never mind. I just let you try again. Waiting for them to bring water, okay? Open eye. Can you see from here to here? And if open eye, far and near, but close your eye, from here to here, and this is we call outside. If you can see outside from here to here, then you can see inside. Your calmness or a bit of thought coming, or calmness more or a bit thought, you can see. Can you stay in between, see both body and mind? And how to stay in between? Just now, move your hand again. Can you see from, can you see the front and the back? You never see back, backwards. You never see, you only focus. That is wrong concentration. Can you see back, backwards? Because you turn inwards to go to stream entry. More you turn inwards, you got enlightened the first one, stream enter. And now, just, I think you dress your hair every morning. I have no hair, but you have hair. Now, can you dress your hair and see what happened? You see in front, the mirror, yourself, who are dressing hair. And can you see how you touch hair together? The front and the back, can you see? You stay in between already. You go to emptiness. You never go to this state before because you only watch and see forward or the front. You never see the back together. You got duality. And now if you open eye, can you see far and near? Left and right? From here to here, can you see? More than meditation. This is we call emptiness, sunyata. When you practice meditation, first step you got calmness, we call meditation. Second step you got vipassana, we call insight meditation. And next step you got sunyata. Okay? Now I got this technique, okay? To help teaching you go to realize sunyata. Because I write my dissertation in PhD about sunyata emptiness. Okay, and I just do my workshop, okay? Just see how I can go into emptiness. The concept of emptiness is non-duality. Now you got duality, okay? Rich and poor, good and bad, happiness, unhappiness. You can see both and not involved. How to see both and not involved? Can you see the body from the front to the back? Now dress your hair or move your hand back. You never see backwards. Can you see backwards? Now I see my drinking, but I can see my body always awareness. This is the front, but I can see my body awareness. Awareness, not only the front, awareness of the whole body. As far as you got full awareness, and you can see full awareness, you got sunyata. This is the latest of my knowledge. More practice, I know the access go into sunyata, very simple, okay? Can you see what you drink and see from here to yourself? From here to yourself, who is drinking? Together, from here to yourself, who is drinking? Sunyata. Okay, again. First, you look at me, open your eye. You only watch in front, and you never see yourself. First, can you watch in front? This is your mind. Can you see from here to here? This is your awareness. Okay? Watch with good awareness of all around. But first, you cannot see all around. I can see all around, okay? First lesson, can you see from here to here? From here to here? Can you see? Now, can you see from here to here? And watch me. Watch me is your mind. See from here to here is awareness, and you got consciousness wake up. We call consciousness. If you can see from here to here, you got eye consciousness wake up. Eye consciousness wake up. For example, when you go skiing, you watch the way you go skiing, okay? But you see from here to here and jump, okay? When you ski, you watch in front and see things around because you have to be careful, okay? You don't know this way, that way, good or not good, maybe some problem with snow, okay? You have to see from here to here or not. And you watch in front or not? Watch in front, we call mind. See from here to here, we call consciousness. Now you know, you come to meditation, or you come, you stay here in Melbourne, your mind wash your job, wash the way you going, but you have very poor consciousness because you stay in Melbourne. You know every way how to get to your office. Okay? You don't have to be mindful awareness a lot, but when you go ski, wash and your eye consciousness wake up. Okay? You know, seeing, everybody got seeing, but how you got seeing clearly? Your mind watch, your eye look. I told you, your eye look, your mind inside watch, but sometimes you lost, you not wake up. But when you go skiing, you look, watch, and wake up, see from here to here, you got consciousness. Watch, you got mindfulness. Mindfulness and awareness or consciousness, that is the best quality of your mind, okay? Now, can you see from here to here? The long breathing. You watch here, watch the breathing at one point here, inside, touching or in front, but can you see together from the beginning to the breathing inside? Can you? Very calm. It go to emptiness from the beginning. Now do it again. Open eye, watch only on the touching of your breathing in your nostril. Can you watch? But can you see from here to here? No outside, no inside. See both from outside to inside. Just feel together. Relax. More relax, you got more awareness. More awareness, you got consciousness. Wake up. And see from here to here, we call see by awareness, or the result is consciousness. Wake up. Now close your eye, watch here only. But watch from your mind and see from your mind from here to here. Can you? Can. Everybody can. Simple. Watch in front. Watch. Focus. But together, awareness and see from the front to inside. That is the Buddha tell you to start, watch and see on knowing clearly long breathing. From the beginning, starting to the pause inside. And now, even you open your eye, just practice in daily life. Walk on the street, you must watch the way. But you must see yourself who walking together. Can you? Now you sitting, listen to me. You watch me, but you must see yourself together. I see from there to here, far and near. Then I don't have to close my eye, practice meditation, because my mind become emptiness already. You practice calmness meditation for what? For emptiness, okay? And emptiness with wisdom, that means you must see from outside to inside, okay? That is see your mental quality. Can you see how you sit and how you feel? This is vipassana, okay? Because you see from outside to inside, but you watch only one object, that is watch master. Now you watch master, but can you see how you're doing, how you're feeling? Can you see how you're doing, how you're sitting, how you're feeling, but you watch me. So I would like to tell you, you can watch any object. Now you watch me, you got meditation. But must watch from inside, connect. More connect, go back. I look, my watch, how to watch me with attention. What is attention? I speak loud. Can you hear something quiet or more quiet in this room? Doesn't matter what you hear, quietness in this room. Your mind got attention, how your mind work. When your mind listen to something more quiet, your mind become more attention, that's right. So when you got attention, you got mindfulness. That is how you got mindfulness. Connect your eye to your mind, look and watch. Connect to your ear, to your mind, listen and hear. You got attention, you got mindfulness. And how it is when you got attention and mindfulness, you got mindfulness, attention for 5 minutes, you got calmness, 5 minutes. But when you got five minute calmness, can you see together from outside to inside? More calmness, you can see clearly from outside to inside. That is, you can see the four foundations of mindfulness: body, sensation, mind, and mental quality. How you can see from outside to inside and not involved. Normally, you always stop at the station. You want to go to Brisbane, Queensland, but you stop long time at Sydney, then you cannot go arriving at Queensland or Brisbane, okay? You always enjoy Sydney, Opera, how, or whatever, then you cannot get into this destination, okay? So now you not waste your time to stop, okay? To stop at the station, each station, okay? You know you can practice meditation, concentration, only one station, on the body station, on your breathing, but your awareness seeing must be more clever. See the whole station, okay? Now can you watch me? How your mind work? Your mind got calmness. Can you see calmness more or less? When you see calmness more and more, wake up in the calmness. See from outside to inside together, can you? You never wake up in the calmness. When you got calmness, you not see anything and fall asleep or lost in thought, okay? Can you wake up in the calmness? See outside, inside, that is, outside is your body, inside is your mind or your heart or your feeling. Can you see how you're doing, how you're feeling? Open eye, you watch me, you see how you're doing, how you're feeling. Cross your eye now, you watch your breathing, but you see from outside to inside, can you? More watching your breathing every moment, more good and good mindfulness. When you have good mindfulness, why? Why not see outside and inside together? Why not see from body to your sensation, mind, and mind quality? You can see. This is vipassana. You can see. Just do it now. You can see. You can see at least how you're doing, how you're feeling together. You can see even you watch your breathing. But when you see outside to inside, you focus the first foundation. See the whole sitting posture. You try to look into your mind, then you lost again. So, open your eye. Can you see from the front of the body to the back of the body? See the feeling. This is, you must stay established well on the body foundation. And then, when you can see body foundation, the whole body foundation, then you can see, can you see body and in the body, that is your breathing. And can you see body in the body and sensation? Then it will bring you see more and more by itself. Now, before you close your eye, start with body foundation. We call Kayakata Sati. Can you see the whole body sitting clearly? That means see from left to right, front to the back. Can you see the whole body clearly? Then when you see the whole body clearly, this is the power of meditation. Okay? When you sit, your body not go down. Your body straight up by itself, that's right. Can you see the whole body clearly? And to make sure you see clearly, how to make sure you see clearly? Your body straight up by itself. Before you try to straight up your body. But you not see the whole body clearly from the front to the back. Then 2 minutes, your body go down. 3 minutes, 5 minutes go down. Okay? So you must be mindful of the body as the first foundation. We call mindfulness of the whole body. We call Kayakata Sati in Bali word. Now, I'm not lost. I can keep calmness the whole day and more emptiness together because I see my whole body. Because difficult for those who never learn, they only see outside, that is see other people's body, not see himself, his body himself. But now even you see your body yourself, you must see the whole body from the front to the back. Can you? If you cannot, try again. But if you can, don't have to try. Can you see? Back. The front, everybody can see, but the back. Now you can see both. Now, cross eye and see the whole body, posture, sitting posture. Your body become uprising by mindfulness, not by your strengthen the muscle, okay? That's right? This is the latest technique that I found. This is really helpful to you, okay? If you can see both, the whole body, sitting posture, walking posture, standing posture, you become absorbed in meditative state already. You don't have to try to practice any meditation because you got very good mindfulness, whole body mindfulness, very good mindfulness already, okay? And now, how to see more inside, okay? I just give you the knowledge to see how to see inside. Just follow me. If you can or cannot, or just a bit can do, okay, don't worry, because this is the first day. Now, can you see body and your feeling? But what happened if I told you smile? Can you got deep smile? Don't have to keep your face smile, but got gladness in your heart. Can you keep gladness in your heart? Gladness. Your heart open. Gladness. So the Buddha say, with gladness in your heart, you got Dhamma eye, seeing releasement. What releasement you see when you got gladness in your heart? Desire releasement. Okay? Attachment releasement. The Buddha say, gladness in your heart, you see dispassion, releasement, and letting go all attachment with gladness in your heart. So if you practice meditation without gladness, with seriousness, you cannot go to the way the Buddha teaching, okay? Gladness, especially if you can, gladness with loving kindness, okay, in your heart, and compassion more in your heart. With gladness, this is your heart. Wake up. And don't forget your mind. See from the front to the back of your body first, and see the whole body outside and the body inside, that is your breathing. And when you see the breathing inside, you can see sensation and mind and mental object. But when you have gladness, you got good and wholesome state in the mental state. Wake up. Now with gladness and see both together from outside to inside. See how you're doing, how you're feeling together, and with gladness. With gladness, the Buddha say, you can see dispassion. And you can see releasement. And more releasement. And more releasement. And letting go. You not, don't know how to let go. Can you see, can you got gladness first? If you got gladness, you can letting go, okay? Gladness in your heart with trust in the Buddha, and see both body and mind, that is body sitting posture clearly. And then when you can see both body sitting posture clearly, you can see breath body, and more, you can see breath body inside. Okay? Today, I just want you be able to see breath body outside and inside. Can you? But if you want to see more and more, you need maybe today retreat, Saturday, Sunday, okay? Now focus here, but see the whole breathing, can you? With awareness from heart. Watch your breath on the touching in your nostril, but see from your nostril inside and how your breathing go in into your body inside, and more smile, it go deep inside. Can you see both from outside to inside, the breathing in long, and the pause inside? Just feeling from your heart together, feeling your breathing together. When you feel your breathing together, you can feel the pause inside, and then you can see the breathing outside, from the starting to inside, even you focus the breath in your nostril at the touching. But you can see the whole breathing. Gladness more and more with trust in your heart. Gladness more and more with trust in the Buddha and trust in your practice. Gladness, very important. See the body relaxing, see your heart gladness. Can you see
both all together, from outside to inside, your body relaxing and your gladness in your heart together? Can you see by smiling to yourself inside? When you smile, you got more awareness. Smile to yourself with gladness. Your heart open and wake up. And more awareness from heart by feeling together. When you watch your breathing, feel your breathing together, then you can see from here outside to inside deeply, feeling together. Okay? Then you got non-duality. More than concentration, more than calmness, you go to sunyata, emptiness, okay? And feel your heart become one with earth. That is, feel your sitting posture on cushion, whole sitting, touching on cushion or touching on earth firmly. Can you feel your gravity on earth? When you feel more your heart, feel your body more on earth, your heart more open up. Then you can see from breathing outside to breathing deep into your emptiness. That is your heart. Now, if your heart emptiness, how your heart emptiness? Just your heart feeling you are sitting on earth 100% or maybe more and more. Can you feel? Then you had more awareness and you had become opening more and more. Then you can see outside and more inside deeply from your breathing, deep and deeper to your cushion, deep and deeper to earth. And your heart wake up and unboundedly emptiness and your heart become one with the nature. Feel you are sitting on earth. More and more you connect to earth and what happened? Your heart become one with earth. Your heart then become one with the whole nature. Now you're not feeling yourself sitting on earth, even you sit on earth. You walking on earth, you never feel yourself walking on earth because you never connect to earth. You don't have good awareness of your walking on earth. Now you're sitting on earth, even you're sitting on the building on earth or not, can you just sit and feel you're sitting more and more deeply on earth? Your heart become expanding with gladness and unbodily emptiness. And stay there. When you stay there, it become absorbed, nicely absorbed. Even in emptiness, can you see, not only in emptiness, you must see outside, how you sit, how you breathing, and how emptiness inside. You must see both, outside, inside, inside, outside, what the Buddha explained in the for foundation of mindfulness or satipatthana 4. Now you got awareness from heart. Awareness and see, awareness and see, awareness and see, awareness and see, more and more inside. And quiet. When you seeing inside, need quietness. I'm not speaking for 5 minutes. Quietness.
with gladness, more gladness, and trust in the Buddha.
See feeling inside and feeling outside of your whole body together. Just stay in between, seeing inside and outside together, clearly. Inside is your heart, gladness, and trust in the Buddha. Outside is your relaxing body, sitting with relaxing, with more awareness, with earth. Can you feel yourself sit on earth? Your heart become opening up, expanding, become one with the nature all around. With gladness, you are breathing more. Absorb breathing deeply. It become more and more. If you got gladness, you got awareness of breathing inside everywhere in your body. More and more if you have gladness. It looks like you are breathing. You go everywhere in your body and it looks like you got breathing on the whole body skin if you have gladness. If you don't have gladness, you only breathing only in and out on your nostril only. Can you got gladness? And breathing inside with gladness, it become absorbed to everywhere on your body, everywhere. And with breathing everywhere, inside and outside the whole body, you got very good calmness of body and very good calmness of mind. From all distraction, you feel contentment and equanimity. Now, just stay there, knowing clearly, seeing clearly, not involved. It becomes equanimous. More equanimity, more emptiness. More emptiness, more seeing clearly. All defilements inside and see releasement and letting go and see freedom of mind. Now, even you open eye, you got automatically awareness of your breathing more and more as home and don't have to focus your breathing. Can you feel your breathing? Because your breathing become awareness everywhere inside. You just know your breathing with awareness. Or more feeling your breathing inside. And how? Feeling your body outside together. Body, physical body is body outside. And body inside is your breathing inside. The Buddha's teaching, just knowing clearly your body outside and body inside. Body inside is your breathing. Can you awareness of your body, inside? You stay in between. Then when you stay in between, you can see sensation outside and sensation inside. Then you can see mind and mind inside, and mental quality and mental quality inside. And what inside mental quality inside is your attachment. It's your attachment is the inside. The mental quality inside is your attachment. Now just train your mindfulness to know the body outside and inside. Can you know your movement and you got movement of the body? You breathing or not? But you never awareness of your breathing. So you got obstruction from the first foundation. You cannot know body outside, inside. You got duality. When you got duality, you got thought. Okay? And when you close your eyes, just stay in between. We call good awareness, not go out, not go in too much, but stay in between, knowing both out and inside. In the beginning, you might stay in between, can stay in between 1 minute, that is good enough for you for the first time. But more 1 minute, it become more, 2-3 minutes, okay? Today, maybe 1 minute is good enough to learn, okay? But come, how to stay in between, know the body outside, inside together. Body outside is your body, physical body movement. Inside is your breathing inside. Can you know both? When you know both, you got more awareness and consciousness sleeping inside your subconscious more wake up. This is knowing in between you got awareness, got consciousness wake up. But more awareness will be good quality if you have the power of concentration. Watch only one object that is. Watch your breathing on the clear touching inside your nostril or in front of your nostril, doesn't matter. But not fix one position, because usually you breathing in, breathing out in different position, okay? And you don't understand, you just fix one point, then you lost. You just watch the touching. Sometimes touching clearly inside or outside, can you just realize the touching? Normally you fix the position on the end of your nostril here, on the limb, on your lip, on your limb here, on the nostril, then you lost. But actually, you're breathing in, breathing out, touching different position, okay? Can you watch the touching? But when you watch the touching, but together, can you see both outside, inside? With awareness, watch with your mind. Aware and see the whole breathing inside with awareness, and you got consciousness. Okay, wake up. Somebody crossing eye, but somebody open eye. If you open eye, you must have object of meditation. Maybe you can watch me if you open eye. But can you see me and see yourself how you sit? And you can see more inside, how you sit and how you breathing? Can. Then you stay in between, the middle way, middle part.
bringing you to equanimity of mind, and the emptiness there. And how to develop more awareness? I give you more technique. Now you always learn by focus from your mind, but actually you can focus by awareness. I show you how to focus by awareness. Open eye, even your eye with me, can you feel your arm? Can you feel? If you can feel your arm, you can notice from heart. Because you feel your arm from heart, you got awareness and see. Awareness and see, cool or warm. Can you just feel and see warm on your arm? Can you feel and see warm on your arm? You see from heart? Can you notice together? Awareness of warm or sensation? Can you awareness of sensation warm on your arm? And can you notice in your awareness? This is how to focus from awareness. This is more inside meditation, okay? Awareness and notice now, very simple. Just feel your arm first. Doesn't matter cool or warm, or maybe warm or cool, or sensation, or maybe you can feel pulse, or you can feel only sensation, doesn't matter. But when you feel, you got seeing from heart. It's seeing from heart awareness. When you seeing from heart, can you notice together in your seeing how sensation is? Can you notice together? Or how notice together? Can you touch your power now? Touch. Everybody just touch your power. I will teaching you awareness and watch or notice from awareness. Can you feel your power? If you can feel your power, no thought already. Because I just let you move your thought, shift your thought to your feeling. When your thought shift you to your feeling, you get into calmness already. But how to wake up in calmness? Can you feel your power? No thought already. That is, your mind come back to your heart, and your mind can notice. Can you feel your power? And can you notice how fast, slowly, or steadily your power is? Can you notice? This is we call awareness, and put concentration from awareness. Okay? This is good. Good to put concentration from awareness. Inside, your power is sensation, that's right? Okay? Normally, if you focus sensation from your mind, very tense. But if you just awareness and notice sensation from your heart, very calm, okay? And mindful awareness, okay? Can you notice your sensation again? Touch your power? What you notice, your power sensation. From your power sensation, you can notice your power sensation go on everywhere of your body sensation. It connect together. Can you notice your power sensation? It become connect or bring you to notice the whole sensation of the body? And you know, sensation of the body from your heart. And can you now lift your power? Can you notice the whole sensation? And don't have to touch your power now. Can you notice? With awareness and notice, awareness and notice. Awareness and notice, awareness and notice. This is how to watch sensation. Because when you watch sensation from heart, you can realize sensation, it comes your heart or your mind here, emotion. If you have unwholesome, bad emotion, your power really rough and glossy, okay? But if your heart with loving kindness, your power or your sensation very smooth and very comfortable.
And when you notice an awareness from heart, you can notice an awareness in the mental state, in your heart, got any desire and attachment. Now, can you notice and aware in the mental state? If cannot, start again. From body sensation, can you feel pulse? If you can feel pulse, you can feel the whole body sensation, that's right? If you can feel power, notice power, you can feel the whole body sensation and notice the whole body sensation, can you? When you can notice the whole body sensation, that is how to watch sensation. Now you can watch sensation from inside, not from outside. This is your mind, only concentration from your conceptual thought, that's not good, okay? You have here we call bare attention, pure attention, see things as they are. Okay, now, can you feel sensation, no sensation, notice sensation of the whole body generally, can you? And what you found that sensation of the body come from your emotion. Your emotion not good, oh, your body disturbed. Your emotion good with loving kindness, your body sensation calm and nice and consciousness. And can you notice by heart, in and in? Because if you watch your breathing, you can watch. You watch your sensation, still can watch. But if you watch in and in your heart inside, I don't think you can watch. Cannot. But you can notice. Your heart can notice your heart inside. But if you just use your mind to watch, you can watch your breathing in, breathing out, watch sensation of the body, watch sensation of your heart might be difficult. And watch the mental state inside, no, difficult, very difficult. Maybe you got lost, okay? But if you just start with concentration, meditation, watch and aware with feeling, watch your breathing, feel your breathing together. Feel your breathing and watch. Can you do both? Then when you watch, you got calmness. When you awareness or feel, you got wake up. Wake up, it become turning inwards. Awareness more and more inside and notice. Can you just aware of your heart and notice? Maybe I ask you, how are you today? You told me from your heart, I'm fine, Master, I'm really happy today. You notice, can you notice? You don't have to think. You tell me straight away from your spirit and soul, I'm fine, Master. But maybe you got thought, Master, I have some problem when you got thought. Okay? But actually, you can notice inside your heart by awareness. Okay? I'm fine, Master. How you know? You know by heart. Your heart know your heart. And if your heart know your heart can listen to your heart. Can you listen to your heart when you speak? You got any emotion, good or bad? Can you listen? Okay? Can you listen to your heart? Not by ear, by heart. Because when you can notice, you can listen. Can you listen to your heart when you speak or before you speak? What you got in your heart? You got desire? You got expectation? Why you speak like that? Because you got expectation. Okay? Can you listen to your heart? When you think, listen. When you think good, when you listen to your heart letting go. When you think bad, can you listen to your heart? Your heart got desire. Can you listen to your heart when you're doing in a rush, your heart really, really hot, okay? When you're doing calmly, your heart really calm, okay? When you can listen to your heart, you can see condition arising in your heart. Can you see condition arising in your heart? That is, you got inside attachment that make you suffering, and what you see inside more, oh, attachment from your desire. And what you see your desire from, or you see desire from you lost mindfulness, you got satisfaction or dissatisfaction, then you got desire or desire not to do or desire to take it. If you got satisfaction, you got desire to take it more and more. If you got dissatisfaction, you got desire not to take it, okay? You can see desire, okay? If you can see desire, then you can see this is the cause of suffering because it makes you attachment. And now, how can you see? You see by awareness. You not see by thought, you see by awareness. How are you today? How you know you good, feel bad? You know by your awareness. You don't have to think, master. If you think, maybe you got bias. Okay? You got bias. If you feel, okay, good is good, bad is bad. If you think, maybe you speak not the right according to your feeling. Okay? Okay, now can you connect your speaking to your heart? When you speak from your heart, you got more letting go, more inside meditation. Now when you speak not the same as you feel, okay? Then you cannot develop vipassana, okay? You must speak from heart. Can you see from heart? Your eye see monk, you enjoy seeing monk. If you enjoy seeing monk, you see from heart, okay? So more enjoy or gladness. If you got gladness, you see monk from heart. Okay? That's why the Buddha say, with gladness you develop Dhamma eye, seeing dispassion. Seeing more dispassion, you can see releasement or desire and attachment. And more releasement, you can see liberation or freedom of mind or the Buddha nature. Now can you see you are far from freedom because you got caught in jail of emotion. Can you see? You don't see by eye, but you see by heart. You know how you got inside attachment, desire, anger? Can you know? Know by heart. When you can know by heart, by awareness, it looks like you can see more clearly why you got desire, why you got anger. You can see more clearly the cause of your desire. It comes from your satisfaction and dissatisfaction. And now you just let go. Satisfaction and dissatisfaction, can you just don't lose in your satisfaction and dissatisfaction? Not lost, can you? Then you can let go. People ask me, Master, can you, how let go? I don't know how to let go. You're not lost. When you got satisfaction, not lost. And when you got dissatisfaction, not lost. Then you can let go. Okay? No, you know how to let go? You got something very happy. Oh, a lot of satisfaction. When you got something unhappy, you got a lot of dissatisfaction. Too much. Then you cannot let go. So start when you got even something make you happy, just know your happiness, okay? Not lost with satisfaction. And when you got dissatisfaction, you can leave it, okay? Let go really fast, okay? So now can you see by your awareness? By your awareness, you can see mental state. By your mind to focus, you can see only the breathing in, breathing out. This everybody can see. But only those who more mindfulness and awareness inside. With awareness inside, will bring you turn inwards to see condition arising inside. And what conditioning arise inside? That is, you see suffering. And then when you suffering, you can see why you got suffering. Oh, because you got attachment. And then you can see why you got attachment. Because you got desire. And why you got desire? Because you got satisfaction and dissatisfaction. Okay? And if you can see satisfaction and dissatisfaction, not lost. Okay? If not lost, then you can let go easily. This, you already see. Paticca Samuppabbata. This is Bali word. In English, we call dependent origination. who see dependent origination or conditioning arising or paticca samuppabbat in Bali word. The Buddha say, you see Dhamma. You got Dhamma eye. What we practice, calmness, meditation, watch and see from mind, awareness and see sensation, and bring to see sensation of the whole body, bring to see sensation inside deep in your heart. Then in your heart sensation, you can see desire attachment and the cause of desire attachment. Then you can see things depend on each other. We call conditioning arising. Can you see conditioning arising? With eye open, it will help you see more conditioning arising, because when you got eye open, you got contact. When you got eye contact, you got emotion. I got emotion also when I got eye contact. But I can let go very fast. Okay? Can you see emotion when you got eye contact or ear contact? People speak good, how you feel? Can you see how you feel? People speak bad, can you see how you feel? You see Dhamma, because you see condition arising. And you see why you got happiness, unhappiness. Because you got satisfaction and dissatisfaction. And you know, in the practice of sati patthan, or for foundation of mindfulness, there are two paragraphs. First paragraph, the Buddha just let you train your mind, mindfulness and awareness, see body and body in the body, sensation and sensation in the sensation, and then mind and mind in the mind, mental object and mental object in the mental object. And the second paragraph, the Buddha say, whatever you see, body, sensation, mind and mind object, just let go satisfaction and dissatisfaction in this world. When you can let go satisfaction and dissatisfaction, you see the freedom of mind. You see the enlightened path to the Buddha, to the enlightened, as the Buddha saying, okay? Now what you see, you only see breathing in, breathing out, and you got expectation, but you not see this expectation make you got satisfaction and dissatisfaction. Your expectation is today, I will go very deep calmness. But if you not get good calmness, you got upset. So don't worry. Everything impermanent. Today maybe you do good calmness, tomorrow maybe not good calmness, doesn't matter. Can you let go this satisfaction and dissatisfaction? This is the point, okay? If you can let go satisfaction, dissatisfaction, you see Dhamma. Because you free your mind from attachment, okay? Okay, now I just want you to know what is the goal in practice samatha and vipassana. Not only the first paragraph, now everybody only training in the first paragraph, the Buddha say, seeing body, body in body, sensation in sensation, mind in mind, mental object in mental object. Never, or maybe not all, maybe most people forgot the second paragraph. Let go all satisfaction and dissatisfaction in this world, not only in the practice. In this world. Okay, you got satisfaction and dissatisfaction when you got eye contact, ear contact. Can you let go satisfaction and dissatisfaction? Very quickly, let go quickly. No, satisfaction, just maybe, okay, enough, and let go. If you can let go satisfaction and dissatisfaction really quickly, you go near to the Buddha enlightenment. So today I think it's enough, 9:30. If you want to train more, I will teach you step by step, because now it from my spiritual, you maybe get maybe 5, 10, 15%, 20% anyhow, don't expect. Don't expect to try to know everything what I'm teaching today. Know as much as you can or as listen as you can. Don't worry. If you let go satisfaction, dissatisfaction, you got nearer to the Buddha enlightenment, okay? Sathu, sathu. Okay, good. You know what is the purpose in the practice. Let go satisfaction and dissatisfaction. Not expect anything, okay? Do the best, but not expect anything. I wish to see you this Saturday, Sunday. I have day long retreat, step by step, from mind to heart, and to wake up your heart and see noble truth and see conditioning arising and listen. I need to give you more workshop, okay? Okay, thank you so much.